Hi, this is Arvind. In a previous video, we discussed about what are non-PO invoices. In this video, we'll talk about the end-to-end process flow of non-PO invoices. We'll generally talk about how the non-PO invoices are received in a system, how those invoices are processed in the system. Before processing, what are the checkpoints for non-PO invoices, the maker checkup process, and the approval process. So let's start with the non-PO invoice process flow. So we will briefly discuss about the generic flow of non-PO invoices, right from receiving invoices until process for payment. Invoices are generally received at the front office, and once inverted by the front office, it is sent to the accounts payable team. Invoices received in AP teams get allocated as per expense type. Once this invoices gets allocated as per expense type, when I say expense type, these are the different type of expenses within non-PO. So type of expenses within non-PO could be utility bill, right? And then government or taxes bill, and employee reimbursement bills and other expenses. Okay, the first step is to check whether invoice coding is done or not. If invoice coding is not done, send the invoice back to the coding team. Do not try and code yourself, because this is not in your role. It has to be done separately by the coding team. If the coding is complete, you will need to check if the invoice is approved by the business. When I say invoice is approved by the business, it is, these are those people who knows about the services or the goods delivered against the invoice which is shared by the vendor. So they have to approve. It means they have to recognize the services or the material which is received and approve it. Once they approve it, then the invoice goes for the processing into a system. During the processing, if there is an exception, then the exception work has to be resolved. If there is no exception, then it goes directly to the ERP system for the payment and for the processing. In case invoice is not approved by the client or the business, then the invoice has to go for the approver, and this has to go through the workflow system to check the supporting documents, and this has to be approved. Once it is approved, then the invoice will be keyed by the AP department for the processing. So that's a high level view how the invoice, which is a non-PO invoice, moves from one level to another level within the AP system. So coding refers to the assignment of the general ledger and cost center to be charged for the amount of invoice received. All these non-PO invoices, bills, statements needs to be allocated to the right cost center for allocation purpose. In the large organization, this coding work is managed by account specialists who have authority to allocate account and cost center code and send the invoices, bills to approver for approval, and then invoice is finally routed to the accounts payable team to punch in AP system. Return the invoice to the coder if it needs correction. If the coding details are not matching in the system, then refer to the established process or policy. AP specialist will return the invoice to the person who supplied the invoice coding. Note that any rework will delay the invoice processing, leading to business and discount impact. Some companies allow a general practice to refer to the old invoices of same vendor and use that coding to process the invoice. This can save time, but there is a risk. Accounts payable specialist should not use different code unless approved by the authority. Preparation for the non-PO invoices. Now let's get into granular details in processing of non-PO invoices. Invoice number and date. So invoice number and date of issue is the primary input to start with. If these details are missing, then do not proceed further until cleared by your supervisor. There is an exception like utility bills, electricity, credit card, phone bill, they may not have unique invoice numbers. Check the numbering standard policy and if needed, use the standard process to key the invoice number. In case of utility bills, perhaps one example could be combination of the customer number, month and date that can be used as unique reference number. Important is a standard process has to be followed, and idea is to ensure that the duplicate payment is avoided. You have to check if the invoice is approved by the authorized person or not. Check if appropriate accounting code is mentioned on the invoice or not. If the wrong accounting code is used, then the invoice will go to the different expense code. Check if it includes previous balance and other charges. Investigate if previous balance charges are paid. Two-way match is done between the invoice receipt and the supporting documents. So these are some preparation for the non-PO processing. So how are you going to check the accuracy of the invoice? Ensure that invoice coding is correct. An accounting system is accepting the GL code and cost centers provided by the coding team. All non-PO invoices are approved digitally on a workflow or on email with details of approver. When I say details of approver, it can be name, designation, employee number, etc. Check if vendor record exists in the system. If not, follow the process and work with vendor management team. Ensure that vendor details in the system are exactly matching with the name of invoice. It is always advisable to cross-check other 2 to 4 parameters before punching the invoice. Because a name can be similar, you will need to also in that case check the address, the bank details, and other tax details, etc. Because there could be many vendors with the same name, and especially in case of non-PO invoice, payment may go wrong to another vendor as 3-way matching control is missing in non-PO invoices. Accurate input of invoice details is critical. That can be ensured by adding a make a checker process. Review and approve. Non-PO invoice is reviewed by a person who has knowledge of the goods, services received, then approved by an authority person who has authority as per approval metrics. Reviewer has to confirm the receipt of the goods or services as per company policy. The best is maker-checker policy and segregation of duties. Invoice approver confirms the goods and services received, whereas the accounts payable department has maker-checker control. Each company has a different policy. Threshold limit is defined in company to approve invoices for a limited amount. For example, assistant manager has an approval authority to approve up to 10,000 US dollar or rupees. Manager between 10,000 to 50,000 currency. General manager anything above 50,000. In some cases, certain individuals are identified to approve the certain category of invoices. Example, all utility bills approved by a designated person. All T&E, that is travel and expenses, are approved by another designated person. Credit and debit memos are approved by some other person. The best practice is to annex the name, designation, signature of the person approved, who has approved the invoice. And this can be helpful in tracing the invoice in future. Making corrections. So did you find any mistake in processing of invoice? Please check if you have control to edit the invoice posted or you need an approval. Good control is to seek an approval and then perform edit. Before that, if the invoice is parked in a batch processing or it's an individual invoice, batch processing is group of invoices parked and processed at one time. Batch details get reviewed before it is processed for payment. In a batch process, changes can be made to any field up to the point of posting the batch to the general ledger. If individual invoices are posted and need changes, in that case, only the limited fields can be edited to avoid any impact to the general ledger. For example, invoice number or date change, they are not critical from the GL impact standpoint. Ensure that all changes are documented for audit trail purpose. If the invoice is posted to the wrong GL code, then journal entry to be posted to the correct to correct the accounting code. If the vendor is overpaid or wrong vendor is paid, debit memo to be created, approved and processed in order to recover the amount. If invoice is processed less than the amount which is used, in that case, copy of invoice can be used to process the difference amount. In certain cases, recovery can be done through refund request. I hope now you have clear understanding how non-PO invoices has to be processed as handled. FNACO is a consulting and the training institute. For individuals, we offer domain training, interview coaching, and mentoring for the next level promotions. Subscribe this channel for more content on P2P, O2C and R2R. You can also join Telegram channel for job and knowledge hub. Remember, there is always a demand for right talent and we help you build the same. Keep learning and stay tuned with us.